Moving on to the last and final segment of today's show, I wanted to talk about a team that, I'm not going to lie, historically, this isn't the team that on most Mondays after a full slate of NFL Sundays, people aren't always rushing to talk about the Carolina Panthers, especially given what exactly the team has done since Cam Newton and Ron Rivera and that crazy 2016 team, or 2015 team, I should say, that ended up going all the way to the Super Bowl. They went 15-1. Like, that was one of the better NFL teams I've ever watched. And really, since then, the Carolina Panthers have been struggling to get to the playoffs and a winning record. And when you look at the Carolina Panthers, this is actually a team that going into the season was my sleeper team. I looked at Matt Rhule and the job that last year he was able to do with, let's face it, it wasn't a great roster, and it starts at the quarterback. Now, I totally understand that Teddy Bridgewater, at least to start off this season with the Denver Broncos, has been one of the bigger surprises in the NFL. However, the more I look at the Denver Broncos roster, it's significantly better than Carolina's was last year. And when the Broncos announced that they were going to start Teddy Bridgewater at QB over Drew Locke, it kind of pointed to me that Vic Fangio was just going in the direction of, we have one of the better rosters in the NFL. We just didn't trust Drew Locke as a quarterback to not screw it up, basically. And Teddy Bridgewater is the perfect quarterback who, he isn't really going to give you all the explosive plays in the playbook, but one thing you can count on with Teddy is that he's not going to make mistakes. He is not going to turn the ball over. And Carolina, I think when it came to their quarterback position, they needed a little bit more of a playmaker. But I think the way the Panthers built this team and the job Matt Rhule has done since he's gotten there has really made Carolina a quarterback-friendly place. Because look at the weapons around the quarterback position. Christian McCaffrey struggled to stay healthy last year, but we could all agree, when this guy is healthy, he is one of the best running backs in the NFL. He is phenomenal to watch. He's so talented. He could do everything out of the backfield. He could catch, he could run, he could block. He is one of not only the best running backs in the league, but one of the best players in the league. And then you combine that with the receivers. I'm a huge fan of DJ Moore. He is an explosive play guy. I think he is someone that is only going to get better from here on out. Robbie Anderson, the former New York Jet, he's a guy that can make big time plays. And I think Carolina was a perfect place for Sam Darnold to go to. I totally understand that everyone is going to look at Zach Wilson and everything that he's done with the New York Jets so far and compare that to Sam Darnold and how Carolina's season has started off. But Sam Darnold, in my opinion, just needed a change of scenery. I really believe if he was on the New York Jets, he still would not really be getting the job done and fulfilling fans' expectations in New York just based on everything that was built around him. In a three-year span, he had two coaches in Todd Bowles and Adam Gase. Let's just face it, both of those guys sucked. They weren't NFL head coaches. And Matt Rhule, the Panthers head coach, and Joe Brady, the Panthers offensive coordinator, who was the guy who I think is mainly responsible from a coaching perspective for that LSU national championship a couple years ago. If you watch Joe Burrow, his first year at LSU, he wasn't really that special of a quarterback. Like, going into his senior season, Burrow in mock drafts was getting projected to go in like the fourth or fifth round. And Joe Brady not only made this guy a first round pick, but he made him the best player in college football and led LSU to a national championship. And going into last season in Carolina, right, I had some doubts. I saw Matt Rhule and everything that he did at Baylor and everything he did at Temple, and I'm not saying he did a bad job, but I was curious as to why exactly this guy was so high on so many NFL teams' radar. There were so many teams between the Giants and the Jets, I believe Arizona, that were interested in hiring this guy. And I was curious as to why. But now, after a year plus, I'm all in on Matt Rhule as not only a head coach, but a talent evaluator. I remember before he even coached a game in Carolina, during the 2020 NFL draft, he spent every single draft pick on defense. Everyone. And why is that? Because he was just trying to build as much depth as possible for a Carolina Panthers defense that really wasn't good. They didn't have any real standout players. And when you look at this 2020 Panther draft class between Derrick Brown, who played really well in week one against the Jets, Yetur Gross-Matos, the edge rusher from Penn State, he's played well so far this season. Jeremy Chinn, one of the better young safeties in the league, every time I watch him, he pops. I think the Carolina Panthers, the change of this organization started with the hiring of Matt Rhule, obviously, and then it continued to their most the 2020 draft, where they went all in drafting all defensive players. And I think it has really worked so far. Derrick Brown has been really good, along with Jeremy Chinn, Gross-Matos, Troy Pride, a young corner, and others. Then this year, they draft another corner, J.C. Horn, who had an interception in Sunday's game against the New Orleans Saints. I think he has the potential to be a big-time player. And I understand that people are going to look at the Carolina Panthers and everything that they have done so far this season, right? And they're going to say, come on, it was the New York Jets. We saw just how bad Zach Wilson looked in his week two game against the New England Patriots. And they're going to look at the New Orleans Saints and say, come on, like, I get Jameis Winston played good in week one against the Packers, but that Packer team clearly wasn't ready. They clearly weren't focused. And Jameis Winston, we all know, like, he's a turnover machine. But I'm telling you guys this. I believe in the Carolina Panthers to be a wild card team in 2021. I picked it before the season started, and I'm not going against it. I think that Sam Darnold was never given a fair, realistic shot to succeed as a quarterback with the New York Jets. Not only was the coaching around him terrible, who are his go-to weapons? I get Robbie Anderson was fine for a couple years, but the Jets let him go right away. And he was throwing to Jamison Crowder and Denzel Mims, who can't even get on the field for the New York Jets right now. Compare that to Christian McCaffrey and DJ Moore, and more importantly, the coaching. I'm telling you, Joe Brady is going to be a head coach in the NFL next year. That's how good of an offensive mind he was. And last year, when I watched Carolina with Teddy Bridgewater at quarterback, and once again, last year, this roster, without really a fully healthy Christian McCaffrey for a majority of the season, it wasn't that good, and the Panthers were way more competitive than I would have ever expected them to. I remember they had a Saturday night game against the Green Bay Packers last year. And keep in mind, this is last year's Green Bay Packers, when Aaron Rodgers was playing like the best quarterback in the world, the MVP of the league. Matt Rhule almost led the Panthers with Teddy Bridgewater under center into a win in Lambeau Field in primetime last year against what easily could have been the best team in the NFL from start to finish last year in the Green Bay Packers. And Matt Rhule decided to bring in Phil Snow as the Panthers' defensive coordinator. He's a guy who has been around so many college stops. He's been in the NFL for a year. He was a defensive assistant for the Detroit Lions in 2005, and then he was the linebackers coach in Detroit from 06 to 08. He actually was the linebacker coach for that very famous Detroit Lions team in 2008 that went 0-16, and he has followed Matt Rhule from Temple to Baylor to now the Carolina Panthers. And sometimes, right, when it comes to coaching, I feel like we all, as fans, it's easy to judge head coaches based on their performances in games and whether they decide to go for it on a certain fourth down or not. But the thing that has impressed me with Carolina that I feel like not a lot of people talk about is the coordinators. Matt Rhule decided, hey, even though I have plenty of friends in the coaching business, I'm sure, I'm going to hire the two guys that I think are the best and the guys that I think are going to get the job done. And Joe Brady left LSU, a place where he would have been beloved. He would have been really the king of the hill there at LSU. And I know Ed Orgeron is the guy, his voice, we all love him. But Joe Brady made Joe Burrow. He was responsible for that turnaround. And I think when you combine that with Sam Darnold and the situation that he is in right now, most importantly, with the weapons that this guy has around him, McCaffrey, Moore, Robbie Anderson. There are some really good players on this Carolina Panther team that I think could help Sam Darnold as a quarterback, along with an improved offensive line. I'm all in with this Panther team. Can they beat the Buccaneers and win the NFC South? Probably not. I think that is a little bit too hefty expectations. But I fully expect Carolina, especially after their performance against the New Orleans Saints on Thursday night, on Sunday, I expect that to carry over into Thursday night football this week against the Houston Texans. I think Carolina is significantly the better team there. And there is a good mix of veterans and youngsters when it comes to this Panther team. Like, Shaq Thompson is really the only remaining face from that Carolina Panther team a couple years ago that ended up going to the Super Bowl. He's a guy at the linebacker position that could play for my team any day of the week. They bring in Hassan Reddick and Justin Burris, guys that have been in the league a little bit, but they are really getting their first chance here to succeed. And I've been very impressed, and I'm telling you, the Panthers secondary between Dante Jackson at corner, J.C. Horn, the rookie at corner, first-round pick this past year, and Jeremy Chinn, that is an underrated secondary. And then pass rushers. Has anyone seen Brian Burns play? Like, this guy, the former Florida State Seminole, is an absolute stud. They also brought in improvements for their offensive line. Pat Elflein and, shockingly, Cam Irvin haven't been terrible. And I am all in with this Carolina Panther team, mostly because of Matt Rhule, mostly because of Joe Brady, and their ability to get the most out of quarterbacks. And Sam Darnold, he isn't the best quarterback. But one thing I saw consistently in New York was this guy was just reckless. His decision-making was not good. And in order for that habit to be taught out of you, no matter how much talent you have, you need the proper coaching and the proper adjustments to be made. And I think really, I know it's been two games, that is exactly what Matt Rhule and Joe Brady have done with Sam Darnold. He's looked much more relaxed. He's looked much more poised. And when you combine the other kid I forgot to mention, Terrence Marshall, the young wide receiver from LSU, we remember him. He played with Joe Brady. Joe Brady coached him. He can make explosive plays. He hasn't really been able to get going that much yet, but I think eventually he will. And I got to tell you, I am buying stock in the Carolina Panthers as a sleeper team in the NFC. I really am. I think their defense can make plays. I think their quarterback can make plays. Obviously, you have Christian McCaffrey. And just watch out for the Carolina Panthers. They're a team you shouldn't be sleeping on going forward.